Welcome back to Garden Talk, brought to you by the Penn State Erie County Extension Master Gardeners. I'm your co-host for today, Mike Bailey, and along with me is Ellen DiPlacido. Ellen, are you with us?
I am. Here again, Mike.
Yes, welcome back to the 2021 growing season. Isn't it great?
It's wonderful.
And the weather has been picking up, and we've had some nice March weather, and hopefully, things will continue to improve here as we go along. But first of all, before we get started on things, I want to thank Brian Silvis for this opportunity, to bring these garden tips to the folks down in the Corry and Canadohta Lake area, through his radio stations. That's just wonderful that we're able to do that. So we enjoy doing this. We enjoy preparing and everything that we learn, looking up things and going over things. So if you want to give us a little bit of feedback, you can contact the station and let Brian know exactly what you'd like to hear or what you don't want to hear, maybe. So,
I'd like to add to that also, Mike. I think it is important that if people have ideas or comments, positive or negative, we would really appreciate that.
Yeah, you're right. We like some feedback. We like to know how this is how this is doing and what we might change to make things better. So if you got some ideas, yes, please forward them to Brian. We'll go forward with that. But this year, what we want to do is throughout the growing season, we're going to try to keep this kind of seasonal so that you have information that's pertinent to the time of year that you might see some of these particular issues. And we're going to start off this week, we're going to start about talking about starting seeds indoors. And today we're going to talk about it in general, what types of seeds you might want to do and when you might want to start those. And on the next session, we're going to talk about some of the equipment involved. And then on the third session this week, we're going to talk about, the planting and the germinating and the actual growing. So how about we go ahead and get started, Ellen?
Okay.
When you talk about planting seeds indoors, why would somebody want to do this anyways?
Well, I think there's a lot of reasons why different people might want to do this. They might want a wider variety of plants other than what they might find in their local garden center. And they might be looking for some special hybrids that are more disease resistant and more tolerant to insects and funguses and things like that. Or maybe they'd like to try some heirlooms. Just for the fun of it, I wouldn't suggest planting all heirlooms in your garden unless that's really what you want to do. Other than that, because, like I said, a lot of plants might not be available in your garden center. You might want to start them at home, and they will cost a lot less if you can start your own plants. Seed packets are very inexpensive, and you can get like 50 to 150 seeds in one packet. And so you could save a lot of money if you can start them at home yourself. And it's easier to control pests if you start the seeds indoor. You won't see them being eaten up by the birds and insects and things like that. I like to start it just for the enjoyment of it. And it can be a challenge every once in a while, and I like challenges every once in a while. So I kind of enjoy starting a few plants indoors for myself. And we can also use it as a teaching tool. We can teach children about seeds and how to plant, and we could actually teach adults also. So I think there's several reasons why people might want to start seeds inside. Do you think of anything else?
No, that was more than several, Ellen. was a wonderful picture as to why somebody might want to do this. Okay, in our when we do this, our goal has to be to not just germinate seeds, because most seeds will germinate indoors, but our goal is really to produce healthy seedling transplants that'll be productive in the garden. And you have to remember that some vegetable plants will do well if they're started indoors. Some are a little bit questionable, and some of them are really things you should probably stay away from. So let's take a look at that. Some of the things that do very well if you start them indoors are your tomatoes, peppers, eggplants, broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage, etc. They all do wonderful, and they'll transplant easily, and they'll be productive. Some of the things like, cucumbers, zucchini, summer squash, winter squash, pumpkins, they're a little bit variable. you might have luck doing that, and you probably could, but they do really well if they're direct seeded into the garden.
Right.
Then we have some other things like peas and beans and corn and root crops that you really probably shouldn't try to start indoors.
Right.
For whatever reason, they don't seem to transplant very well into the garden. Now, I'm sure there's some very experienced gardeners out there who are going to say, well, I do it all the time. And maybe you do, okay? And you've learned the tricks. But for the novice gardener, okay, I don't think you should attempt those particular things. And those kinds of things, like I said, the peas and the beans and the corn and the root crops do very, very well when they're planted directly into the garden. So kind of keep that in mind. You know, stick with that, and certainly initially with the tomatoes and the peppers, eggplant, broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage type things for indoor planting. So what are some of the things that you need to really be concerned about, Ellen, when it comes down to trying to start something inside?
Well, lighting is very important. You know, make sure that you have enough light, and we'll talk about that a lot more, but sometimes supplemental lighting is going to be needed because you can't always get enough light sitting your plants in front of a window or something like that. And your growing medium, we're going to talk about that, what kind of soil you want to use in your seed pots, and what type of container and what size of container that you're going to use. It's very important that you pick the correct size of your container and make sure that it's clean, but we'll talk more about that. Temperatures, Mike, I've learned a lot. Supplemental heat is so important. And we'll talk a lot more about the temperature. You need, consistent temperature and consistent moisture. You know, how do you water these seeds and seedlings, and how much water do they need, and don't overwater and don't underwater. So there's quite a bit to talk about, and it's really not that difficult as long as you know what to do and how to do it. So we're going to talk more about that too.
Well, that was wonderful, Ellen. Nice summary and we're going to lean a little bit more into that in our next program. But for today, it looks like we have used up our time. So we're going to sign off for right now. And I hope this was helpful. And I hope you tune in next time so that you can hear about some of the equipment and supplies that might be helpful as you venture into this seed starting. So thank you for now. Bye-bye.
Have a good day.